All right, Rhonda and back pass. In this case, it's coming from a promenade pivot. Now, did you feel, have you opened right away?
Mm-hmm.
So make sure you're moving sideways.
Okay.
And that's just there.
I thought I stopped too.
Continuing. Now,
oh,
want her, yeah, I want her to make sure that she's stacked up and not falling off of her hip. Now, when we go into a pivot, this is what the root of this step is, that we're doing pivots, and what happens instead of following through with another pivot, I'll leave the Rhonda. So what we don't want to do is pull the leg out. It just lands on the side. We can survive. We can do that, but I want a little bit more strength in my Rhonda. So I'm still attached to her right leg. So there's two schools of thought about this. One is to move very slightly towards her standing leg, and the other is to pop the leg off with the inside of the thigh. And when you feel that, then you have to create your own speed by turning this leg. Give me a little pressure. When
right
you feel, yeah, when you feel this, give me a little pressure so that you can send yourself off of that leg.
Like that?
Yeah. Okay. So I'm still treating it as if it's a pivot, except that not coming around for the second half of the pivot. But do have an increase of pressure to the leg here. Okay, so you've been doing a little bit on your own.
I didn't press on you, yeah.
Yeah, so that I can't lead you because you already did it.
Right.
So actually, if we were freestyle dancing, not that this is necessarily a freestyle step, but I should be able to lead this if we're dancing pivots. So we're turning. She doesn't know when it's going to happen. Now you can start to feel it. Now when you feel that, then let your body rotate it over your head as far as it'll go. Late,
oh, okay.
But as far as it'll go. So let's just rock. So you're going to feel now the hips, open hips, the middle,
one at a time.
Yeah, I'm not sure what angle you need to see them. But we don't want to open like a door.
Okay.
Here. So again, I'm having my feeling as though I'm dancing with my partner, of course, mm-hmm. dancing a pivot, and he attacks from here. So that starts my base going. So now this is an unwind from the bottom to the top. This starts my leg and my hips, my upper body and my head. So you can get the head to be fast and bright. And then it's slower when the whole body goes at the same time. But if you just be my little post here for the moment. So if we're going in pieces, it may look like it's all one piece, but I'm actually thinking of one winding from the bottom to the top,
okay.
Head being last. So we're just rocking. Turn to turn. I'm gonna attack that leg. Now can you turn your head?
Oh, is that too slow?
Well, what happens is you jumped off. You still have to be right over your leg. And then make the head really fast. Go ahead and turn, 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 turn. Now, it's also faster if your leg does more of a Spanish kick. So, rondajon from the knee instead of
out.
Yeah, a wide kick like that. So you can make that quick by pulling it in. That's going to be my thought as man is to get this. There's nobody home. Where's your leg?
Right here.
Still a little late. Yeah, but you can see now also if she steps away, how I'm making sure that I have this very straight line of my weight fall here. honestly, the men will end up a lot of times trying to throw the girl off the hip. So I'm trying to make a really straight pole for her to flip around.